Just yesterday, more than a dozen House Republicans voted against legislation that was designed to promote public education about the internment of the Japanese American during World War II. They just didn't like it. Now, who's on that list? Oh, you're gonna be shocked to find out that the 406 to 16 vote had these noes: Lauren Boebert, Mo Brooks, Louie Gohmert, Marjorie Taylor Greene, Thomas Massie, Chip Roy. It's the dumb squad, and they are together once again. What was there something radical about this that they felt compelled to vote against more education? The bill would have created a Japanese American World War II history network administered by the National Park Service to connect historical sites associated with the mass internment of Japanese Americans after the attack on Pearl Harbor launched by Japan's military. Bear in mind, if you don't know this, about 120,000 people of Japanese descent were forced to live in detention camps as a result of a 1942 executive order that FDR signed. Most of those people were American citizens. It is one of the blackest marks on the record of a country that has no shortage of them. And these 16 know-nothings want to make sure that our kids know as little as possible about where we came from. What do you think, Francesca?
Like, it passed, right?
Why it was 406 to 16. They just wanted to go on record as not liking it.
Go on record saying, I don't know anything about this and neither should you.
Yeah.
See, if I don't know it, if Alex Jones didn't talk about it, then it didn't happen. Like, what? It's so gross. And also, half of those people aided and abetted insurrectionists. So, buddy, according to the Constitution, you're out of here. Get out of here. Like, I don't ever want to see Mo Brooks and Louie Gohmert's name anywhere ever. Yeah. Like, how are these people still in office? What are you saying by sticking your neck out like that on this? Is this their like force the vote? Is this their like, we're gonna vote for it even if it doesn't happen? Like, just don't make white people feel bad about our history that, and or maybe it's just straight up like, hey, maybe internment wasn't such a bad thing. Like, honestly, that's it matters now at a time when, of course, they don't care about this because, you know, they're all like okay with any kind of Russian propaganda. But when we're doing ridiculous things in terms of like, you know, firing Russian conductors from their jobs, you know, or just weird anti-Russian stuff that is like, this is not the solution. Don't we understand Russians are also victims of this war and everything that's going on?
Exactly. Yeah. When we talk about the Russian soldiers that are dying, I wish that not a single one of them did. I wish that they weren't there at all. And I hate the fact that people are rooting out Russian products and demonizing individual Russians in America. We need to remember the worst ways we've responded to international crises. We need to learn about that so that we don't bring it forward into situations like this. But they're much more interested in, look, they think that it's critical race theory to teach about the internment. That's all that this is. And they want to reassure their base that they hate and fear and suspect Asian people. All sorts of people, not just Asian people, but also Asian people. Even though, and this is an amazing coincidence, it's the 1 year anniversary of the horrific Atlanta spa shootings. There were gatherings all throughout the country over this. If you don't remember, on March 16th of last year, a gunman opened fire at three separate spas in Atlanta, killing 8 people, including 6 Asian women. The shooter was sentenced to life in prison for 4 of the deaths. And since then, by the way, or in the last couple of years, according to Stop AAPI Hate, there were 6,273 reported incidents of harassment, assault, and discrimination last year. That's up like something like 50% from 2020, with 2/3 involving verbal harassment, 1 in 6 physical assault. Women and non-binary people together reported about twice as many incidents as men. So this is not just history, this is very much our present. It is a deadly situation. We need people to learn about it.
Yeah, I mean, if COVID, you know, were happening in the 30s, 40s, like, and you had a president like Donald Trump calling it the China virus, who's to say that Chinese people wouldn't be interned? Who's to say? Are we so sure that that wouldn't have happened? You know, and honestly, again, we are suffering from the impact of people like Marjorie Taylor Greene, Lauren Boebert, but also really Donald Trump from echoing this poison and Fox News from echoing this poison into everyone's ears day in and day out. And it is horrific. And it's just incredible, like, that women and non-binary people are like number one targets. Like, cool, cool. Yeah, no, please pick on, you know, the most vulnerable of our community.
Exactly. It's just disgusting. And it's bad enough to have those people out there harassing everyone. I don't want them to have representation that agrees with them on these sorts of things.
Yeah.
For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.